They visit a private library where many ancient book collections are kept. They'll see how members of the Ningbo group make donations to finance education.
世界各地的宁波帮都非常踊跃地来捐资办这个学校。They
view the relic of Sakyamuni at Ashoka Temple.
它好像有种吸引力，我刚才刚刚看完，现在又想来看。You're
watching the series Along the Coast.
远方的家，沿海行驶着走，现在来到了被誉为南国书城的天一阁。人们对天一阁总是抱着敬仰的心态，因为古时候啊，很多的文人雅士把登阁、浏览全书当作是毕生的夙愿。那么它到底有什么样的魅力梦绕呢？今天就走进天一阁。在来到这儿的时候啊，天空当中呢下起了一些小雨，这样的天气也会让我们的天一阁之行变得更加特别。
It's been more than 400 years since Tianyi Pavilion was built in 1561. It is China's oldest library and one of the world's first free private libraries. It occupies an area of 26,000 square meters, and it was the residence of Fan Qin, a minister of the Ming Dynasty.
他的最大的爱好啊，就是呢，就他的手中拿的书一样。对，看到了。他就喜欢读书，平时读书，然后他最大的爱好就是藏书。 他读过的书，跟别朋友交流的书都给收集起来，都给他藏起，都没有扔掉。到明嘉靖39年的时候，他就把这些书啊，大概有7万卷藏书，就带回了他的家乡宁波，就都藏在了天一阁里边，是吗？对对对对。Fan
Qin was a native of Ningbo. He simply loved books. Wherever he served as an official, he strove to collect local books, and when he couldn't buy a book he loved, he had it copied.
兵部右侍郎相当于现在的这个国防部副部长。哦，看来范清无论是从财力、精力、物力、人力方面，都是有很大的优势的。包括他自己也很爱收集书籍，才有了现在藏有7万多卷书籍的天一阁，是吧？对，我觉得这个范
Qin loved to collect books all his life. The most precious volumes of these ancient books were local annals and records of imperial examinations of the Ming Dynasty. This library now has a collection of 160,000 books, totaling over 300,000 volumes.
啊，这你看就是天一阁了，它原来就叫天一阁吗？
范清他家里收藏有一块那从江西龙虎山拿过来的一块碑帖，叫《天一词记》。 后来他在翻阅这个《天一词记》的时候，他同时编到有一部我们国家最古老的一部书，叫《周易》的书。《周易》里面在注解里面有一句话，叫“天一生水，地调成之”，他觉得这两个东西又非常合拍，而且“天一生水，水又能克服，藏住了最怕的就是这个火。
对，
所以他觉得这就是天意一样，最后就把这个名字取名为。The
idea that the phrase Tianyi produces water is an observation of celestial phenomena made by the ancient Chinese. Tianyi Pavilion is about 450 years old, and it's always remained intact and safe from disaster.
就我们现在统计一下，你如果要看到真正要看到一本那个明代的一版书啊，你从门口到拿到那本书，要至少要七把钥匙才能打开。七把钥匙，然后分别是给族人保管。对，每个族人拿一把。哦。有几方就拿几把。
In order to preserve his ancient books, Fan Qin made it a rule that no flame should ever be taken into Tianyi Pavilion, and that no book should ever be divided up or taken out of Tianyi Pavilion.
不能带上去，古代没有电嘛，打蜡烛上去它是不允许的。另外抽烟、喝酒的人也不能上去。啊，你看我们这边就看到一个牌匾是“烟酒切忌登楼”，是吧？
对对对。
也可以看出它这个登楼有很多的制度，看书非常的难哈。
但是今天啊也很特别啊，因为他们家族里还有一条规定，
是吗？
就是女子不能登楼的。
女子不能登楼。
所以今天我。 大力瞪了，我是已经破了例了。
哦，这是一个传统的规矩是吗？
对，他们隐藏在家里不成文的一条规矩，不能写出来的。
China developed the tradition of keeping private libraries in the Song Dynasty, and back then there were many famous private libraries. According to written records, there were more than 80 famous private libraries, and the best known of them was Tianyi Pavilion. What treasures await visitors who go inside today?
为什么现在没有通电呢？
这是为了保持天一阁这种年代的一种风貌吧，把原汁原味的传承下来。另外一个，如果通电以后，最有可能就是有可能因电着火，最主要还是防火。所以疏漏最怕的还是火。
这些是。
看看这个，就是刚才我们楼下看到的燕郊切记灯笼的，它的一些管理制度。
这边在楼上还有一个这样的。
对，这是他们正式的一个管理制度。楼下面。再重复一下第一句，你看他
要牢牢记住这个、
对对对，他制作非常的严格，你可以看读给你读一块好了啊。你看第二块放置金牌二，子孙无故开门入阁者，罚不予祭三次。
祭是祭祀，
就祭拜祖宗。
祭拜祖先。
古人祭拜祖宗是一种非常高的，他经常每个月都要祭拜一下，但是如果他不让你祭拜三次，
这是最大的惩罚了，是吧？
是一种是比较
很严厉
的，比较痛苦的一种事情。
Fanqing formulated very strict regulations to protect the books, and the subsequent 13 generations of the family followed the regulations to the letter. It's thanks to their observation of the regulations that these ancient books have survived to the present day.
圣将藏书借书外方，最严厉的就是最后一句，把这个书因而典押事故者，就把这个书给
典押
出去了。除追惩外，就是有惩罚以外，永行秉烛，不得逾期，就是他不再承认是。范清的子孙。
从这个牌匾啊，包括这种镜面，可以看得出来，当时范氏对这个书的珍藏有非常严格的规定啊。
对对对，所以他藏书是他的生命，是一种生命的延续。他希望藏书能够给范氏后来代代子孙都有读书的一种机会吧。
这里边这些就是书柜是吗？
对对对。
The reporter moves forward and sees row upon row of tall black lacquered bookcases.
书柜前面有一个，你看这边。像每一个书柜前面都有这样的一把锁，这个是族人保管的吗，饶老师？
这个一直到民国的时候都是族人保管的，但是这个铜锁是我们后
面后家的是吧？
后来换的，已经不是它原汁原味的这个。
但这些都是吧。
As a result of the strict family rules, people outside the family were denied entry. They were also unable to borrow books from the Tianyi Pavilion.The first exception was Huang Zongxi, a renowned thinker in the late Ming Dynasty. It was Fan Guangxi, Fan Qin's great-grandson, who gave Huang entry.
虽然这边光线不是很好，可能看不太清楚，但是正是因为这样的一种氛围，有一种探秘的感觉。
Mr. Rao is going to open the bookcase.To show them the ancient books here.
七把钥匙的最后一把。
哦，还很紧啊。
对，因为时间久了，有年代了，它的锁有些生锈。
你看这划痕都是这个锁。
对，有点变形了。来，你把我这边拉一下。
这段也可以拉。
对。哇。
我先闻到有一股清香的味道。
对对对。
这是书的
书香，书香。这里面书香可能很大的一部分是因为我们的云香草引起的，天一阁的一个传统。
Rue is a plant that keeps bookworm away. There's a bag of leaves on almost every bookcase in Tianyi Pavilion.
它又干了。
对，你可以闻闻看，它有个香味。
这就是云香草是吧？
对对，云香草，所以书香，很大的跟它有关系。
对，跟刚才打开门那一刹那的那个香味是一样的。
对对对对对。
这是为了保护书籍是吧？
对对对。
哇，这么多都是古书吗？
这里绝大部分都是古书。
以前啊，就是那个看电视的时候，看到古书都会轻轻的吹一下上面的灰尘，这边就感觉它的历史年代感特别的久。那我能打开一本书来看一看吗？
我给你戴个手套，给你拿出来看看。
戴手套是吧？
对，这个一般取书我们不允许。
This tiny detail shows us that those entrusted to preserve the books today also have strict rules for protecting the building and the books so that both will be preserved.
你看你要看哪个，我给你取。
这边吧。
这是一本清代的人，光绪年间写的一本日记，哦、也是一种手稿了。这个应该
手稿是吧？来，我看一眼，稍微正过来一下，我都不敢碰这个。哦，光绪十年是吧？
他刚才写到他法国那里去，去法国的写的
一个游记是吗？
游记游记。哦。这个人可能，
哎，写的字真好看。
对，有可能是我们当时派出去的一个使者吧，就读书。
读书游记。
对。
Only a small proportion of the ancient books still remains here. Most of the others have been moved to a new library.
这个书橱啊，是两面都能打开。
哦，两边都能打开是吧？
另外一边也能打开的。哦，
那我们去那边看看好吗？这边也能打开哈。
对对对，田野狗的特色就是它双面橱能打开以后，这个门板能卸下来，卸下来就放在这个地上。
怎么卸啊？
它这个是轴都能够活动的，这个活动能都能够卸下。你看它这个轴，有一段是槽的，这个槽就能活动，就可以拉下来。这卸下来以后就放摊在这个板，对。
哦。
就把搁在这个地板上，然后把书放
把书摊开，晒书啊。
对，
其实平常的时候会理解成晒书是得放在太阳底下晒书。
对，不是放在太阳底下晒，放在太阳底下晒，它的水分就晒干了，晒干了就书就脆掉了，是不能这样晒的。
就是一个通风的一个作用。
对，主要还是通风。这个拿下来，顺便把这两四面的窗户全部打开。它的特色，他们家的宝树了两边都能打开，那边也有窗户。窗户很多，而且很多都能打开。
这边。
Many details of Danny Pavilion show that Fan Qing thought very carefully about how to preserve his books. Beginning with Fan Guangxie, Danny Pavilion was open to more and more great scholars. Back then, scholars felt proud to be allowed to read the books at Danny Pavilion.
刚刚搬过去。那我们今天来的非常的是时候啊，在这个古书楼里面看到这些古书，非常的珍贵。
Danny Pavilion's modern library has just been opened.
和历史和文化一种超越时空的接触，是吧？很奇妙，也很神圣。
The names of members of the Ningbo group are inscribed on every building at Ningbo University.
接待爱国，做到实处就是办了教师。
The series Along the Coast continues. In order to better protect these ancient books, Danny Pavilion keeps building new storage spaces. They follow Mr. Rao to see a newly built modern archive.
就说原来从在天一阁的这些古书都搬到这个新书库来了，是吗？
对对，这个书库从严格的意义上来讲是我们的天一阁第三代的书库。
哦，第三代书库了，来进去看一下。包还有一个。
No one is allowed to take a bag into the library.
进门就得套个鞋套是吗？
对对对对，因为我们脚里面灰尘比较多，这样可以减少灰尘。
这边入库人员只要不是工作人员都得签字是吧？
只要不是库管员都要签字。
哦。
我们单位的不管是谁进来也要签字。
你也要签字吗？
我也要签。
来，您来签。进门之后啊，先得套上这个鞋套，然后呢，书包也得放在指定的位置。不光这些，还必须得签上自己的名字。看来这一系列都是为了更好的来保护古书，对吧？现在我们就可以进到这个书库里面去看一下。
As soon as the reporter enters the new library.She sees it is spacious and well illuminated.
也就是它的温度啊，要控制在18到22度。
进来之后，明显感觉到里面的温度比外面要温暖一些。
湿度也比较合适，对吧？我们湿度是控制在40到60。
恒温恒湿是吧？
对对对对。
而且进来之后发现好多这样的一个新的这些书柜。
对，这些都是我们新做的书柜，全部是采用。按照国家这种标准，他要求，他对这个书橱也要求。
哇，这边是藏了万卷书啊，一个大书库，而且它都是年代非常久远的这些古书。
这个库房可以大约可以容量20万册，估计这个是我们最大的一个。
20万册的古书是吗？
Exploring this place is like moving along a never-ending hallway of historical memories and artifacts.
而且啊，在这边走，能闻到一种。樟木的香味儿，
对，
淡淡
的樟木香，对。
这是跟这个书柜有关系吗？
对，我们的所有书室的隔板，横的隔板全部都用樟木板做成的。樟木板它本身就有防虫的效果。
This is one of China's most advanced libraries for ancient books. Mr. Rao takes out a key to open one of the brand new bookcases.
这是开这把锁的钥匙是吗？
对对对，你看看，哎，
这个锁非常的特别，嗯，跟这小刀似的，然后上。
The bookcases are quite interesting. Even though they're new, they've been fitted with an ancient style lock. When the bookcase is opened, the smell of old books permeates the air.
这些
香味了吧？云香草的味道，这是这个都是老的云香。
这样的机会是很难得的，能够亲自的去触碰这些文物。
This is the first time this reporter has had the chance to handle such ancient books. She is naturally excited, but she holds the ancient book very carefully, taking care not to damage it.
嗯，
拿着。
虽然说这本书非常的轻，但是确实感觉是沉甸甸的，它是有历史的厚重感在里面。
哎，就这样轻轻的翻啊，因为它不能够折它，这个书翻
会不能折，它很脆弱是吧？
折了以后就留下印记。
哦，这个就是课本。
对，乾隆的课本。
乾隆的课本。
Holding an old book is like having a dialogue with someone from ancient times.
你看这些书保存的都非常的完好，而且刚才饶老师也告诉我，他现在几乎是和原来的时候，几百年前是一样的，是吗？就像您每天都和这些古书打交道，是什么样的一种感受呢？
应该是一种很神圣吧，祖先给我们留下来的不仅仅是一些文物，它更多的一些文化。你看他们的东西，就等于跟我们的祖先在进行交流，来体会他们的读书的乐趣。
和历史和文化一种超越时空的接触，
对对对对，
是吧？很奇妙，也很神圣。
Today, the Tiani Pavilion Museum continues to work hard to protect these ancient books. Every year, it receives many Chinese and foreign visitors who smell the odor of the ancient books. And enjoy their visit here.
从山东那边专程来宁波这边看这个天一阁的。
专程过来看天一阁。
对，那是的。这边的书香非常浓烈。我们经过了几个走廊的时候呢，都有不同的那个书藏书的地方。
A light rain falls on the timbers of the pavilion, and the odor of books tempts people to stay a while longer.
今天来到天一阁，这个雨呢就一直没有停过，下个不停，很有一种风雨天一阁的感觉。而天一阁在保护书籍和藏书这方面呢，确实也是经历了风雨。四百年前甚至是更加久远的古书保留到现在，靠的不仅仅是一种信念，更是一代又一代人们的坚守和努力。除了感谢他们的努力之外呢，这种文化更要从我们的手上更好地传承下去。
Ningbo is a literary city, and its people have always attached great importance to education. In the past, countless Ningbo people traveled to other parts of the world to earn their living. After they became successful, they enthusiastically supported Ningbo's education system.
远方的家沿海巡视着走，来到了宁波大学。这所大学是宁波市唯一的一所综合性大学，而且呢，它也是由遍布在世界各地的宁波帮商人共同捐资建设的。那我们现在就去学校里面看一看。
宁波 University was first built in 1986 with support from Zhejiang University, Fudan University, China University of Science and Technology, Peking University, and the former Hangzhou University. Back then, Deng Xiaoping wrote the name of Ningbo University in his own calligraphic handwriting. Right now, the university has more than 20,000 students and teachers. Every building on this beautiful campus has the name of an overseas Ningbo businessman inscribed on it. The love overseas Ningbo people have for their hometown is obvious.
包玉刚可以说是率先捐资，他当时捐了2000万美金以后，就开始办起来这个学校。等到一旦这个学校正式宣布开学以后，那么全国各地，包括世界各地的宁波帮，都非常踊跃的来捐资办这个学校。他们觉得爱国，落到实处就是办好教育事业。
Pao Yuekong was born in Zhenhai, Ningbo. In 1955, he founded the Worldwide Shipping Group in Hong Kong. After decades of hard work based on prudent operation concepts and a down-to-earth work style, Pao Yuekong became a widely known shipping tycoon. In 1985, he was the first businessman to donate money to help build Ningbo University. Following his example, Run Run Shaw and other overseas Ningbo people also made donations to help build schools in Ningbo.
我们宁波大学接收的捐资大概已经有4亿多了，总共结上。4亿多的这个资金呢，你看看我们这里，几乎每一栋楼，都是有一个海外宁波帮出钱捐资，捐了之后我们政府配套，把这个楼建起来。
From the late 19th century to the mid 20th century, large numbers of Ningbo people traveled to Shanghai, Hong Kong, and Taiwan to start businesses. Some of them even traveled farther afield to other parts of the world to earn a living. A number of them became tycoons, who are now referred to as the Ningbo Group of Merchants. The rapid development of Ningbo University is attributable to the generous donations of the Ningbo Group. So far, Ningbo University has received donations from more than 60 members of the Ningbo Group. It's become a tradition in Ningbo to value education. Today, there are many first-class scholars, scientists, and artists from Ningbo who are well-known in China and even throughout the world. Of the more than 2,000 academicians of the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences and the Chinese Academy of Sciences, 95 come from Ningbo, far more than any other city in China. Ningbo thus deserves to be called the home of academicians. From the example of the Ningbo Group, students have come to realize the importance of giving back and making contributions. They eat with monks in a Buddhist temple.
我说告诉我这儿过斋的规矩就是不能说话，不能吃饭。
They watch a prayer service.
想或者不想，体会一种放下的意境。The
series Along the Coast continues. After driving more than 20 kilometers from downtown Ningbo, the crew arrives at the 1,000-year-old Ashoka Temple in the city's Yingzhou district. The temple is located in the western foothills of the Ashoka Mountains, and as soon as one arrives at the temple gate, you're attracted by its simplicity and peacefulness.
远方的嘉野海行摄制组来到了中国的佛教名寺阿育王寺。这个寺庙也是中国唯一所以阿育王定名的寺庙。那阿育王是一个什么样的人物呢？为什么叫阿育王寺呢？而且啊，我们还听说这里供奉着佛祖的真身舍利。 能不能看到舍利呢？我其实也不知道，那就带着好奇和期待，我们走进阿育王寺。
Ashoka Temple was built over 1,700 years ago in the year 282 AD. The temple is one of the top five temples of China's Chan sect. The temple is well known at home and abroad not only because of its picturesque scenery and towering buildings, but also because it has a very rare treasure, a relic of Sakyamuni.
This is the only one.
1729年的历史。 It is said that in the 2nd century BC, King Ashoka of the Maurya dynasty in ancient India held a grand Buddhist ceremony. He ordered that Buddhist scriptures be compiled and spread around the world to make Buddhism a world religion. He also divided Sakyamuni's remains into 84,000 relics, and he had them sent to be enshrined in temples throughout the world.
This Ayuan is a very special person. It's not that we're now in the TV and TV shows, like in China's Chinese history, it's not that way. Ayuan is a very ancient Buddhist monk, very moral. He has a moral to guide the Five Hindus. The Five Hindus are all belonged to Ayuan.
Ashoka Temple has more than 170 monks, and the number is increasing. As the abbot shows the crew around the temple, a monk emerges from the dining hall and taps a gong under the eave. The abbot explains that this means it's time for the monks here on a retreat to have their meal.
不能讲话是吧？啊，不能讲话了。嗯。打气当中，这个叫精进起，精进，吃着酒瓶用功休息。嗯。嗯。Some
of the monks who come toward the crew in a line have flat wooden sticks in their hands.
有小师傅，也有稍微年长一些的哈。哦，对了。嗯，然后后面拿着这些香板的都是监督的是吧？都是里面的领导的。领导。领导修行。哦，领导修行。At
Ashoka Temple, the monks usually eat a simple lunch at a fixed place. The reporter follows the abbot into the dining hall and sees that it's full of monks. Some of the monks are responsible for serving the food into each monk's bowl. Generally speaking, visitors can eat here in the dining hall too. The abbot sits the crew at the back of the hall. As the reporter is a stranger here, she sits next to an older monk and asks him how things are done.
这个为什么放在这边？你吃，这个啊，行吗？你给你吧，过来一个。哦，把这个碗放在这儿呢。师傅从前面打饭的时候就直接把菜打到这个饭里边。如果说不要的话呢，就直接把这个碗放到这边就可以了。嗯。知道这个吃过斋有什么规矩吗？您能跟我讲讲吗？这不是你不要说话。
The reporter whispers to the master, asking him about the rules for eating here. After whispering something back, the master stops talking and begins eating.
平常想象这个斋饭应该是很清淡的，但是它该少的味儿呢一点都没有少，而且在大冬天，它这边吃斋饭热腾腾的，这种感觉很新鲜，而且呢味道也不错，非常好吃。Because
the monks are on a retreat, the temple prepares two meals a day. The monks get up at 4 in the morning for a lesson. At about 6, they have their first meal of the day, and then they practice self-cultivation. At about 11, they have their second meal. At dusk, there's also a meal, but this one is optional, and many monks eat only breakfast and lunch. This is the first time the reporter has eaten with monks, and there are many things she doesn't know.
这个老师一直告诉我不要说话，不要说话。过斋的时候是不能说话的，所以我现在说话那么声音小。Immediately
after the meal, the monks chant sutras. 在 the conclusion of the meal, the abbot leads the crew into the meditation room.
这个是什么意思啊？这边。The
Chinese characters on the wooden board are the rules to be observed in the meditation room.
哦，用这个次数敲几下，这边三下一下两下来判断来客是谁是吧？啊。什么事情？
就知道，因为坐禅的地方都不能讲话，所以这样的方式，啊，规矩，没有规矩不成方圆。来，进去看一下。At Ashoka Temple, the abbot is called chief monk, and ordinary monks are called masters.
我看到好多师傅在围着一个佛祖像在转圈。When
the reporter follows the abbot into the meditation room, what she sees surprises her.
师傅，您跟我说一下，现在他们是在干嘛？
在行香。
行香啊
啊，行行动的行，
行动的行啊，就一直在走动是吧？围着这个佛祖像，
心里面要。
According to the abbot, the practice probably began over 1,700 years ago. At first, after monks ate food prepared by pilgrims, they divided incense sticks among themselves, lit them, and prayed as they circled the Buddhist pagoda with the incense in their hands. Later on, this gradually became a way for monks to cultivate themselves.
他们在这个运动的时候，脑子里面想的都是要
什么不能想，
什么都不能想啊
啊！就不是不能想，要最好不要想。
嗯，那要达到一个什么样的目的呢？
比如说，人骂我为什么要生气呀？人说我好话为什么我要欢喜呀？怎么样？这是都是空的。啊。
The abbot tells the reporter that in Buddhism.Holding a prayer service makes the monks relax, cleans the soul, purifies and removes blockages, and enhances wisdom.
行香呢是围着一个佛祖啊，进行不停的进行转圈走动，没有次数的规定，但有时间的规定，15分钟的时间。看到他们面无表情，也没有声音，但他们其实呢也会想很多事情，想或者不想，体会一种放下的意境。
The monks pick up the pace and actually begin to jog. This is also a form of prayer. As the monks jog, they mutter some words. This kind of ancient service is now rarely seen. After the prayer service has been in progress for more than 10 minutes, a bell is struck and the monks then return to their seats. Then, several monks carrying iron kettles serve tea to their brothers. Silence reigns in the meditation room again. The only sound that can be heard is the gentle sound of monks sipping tea. After the monks have drunk their tea,They put their teacups on the floor, and several of their brothers collect them. After the monks have rested for a while, they continue their prayer service. More than 10 minutes later, the prayer service comes to an end.And following the prayer service, the monks return to their seats to start self-cultivation.
Now the time is almost 12:00. 所有的师父呢，已经坐在自己的位子上，准备开始打坐修行。
The monks need an absolutely quiet place for self-cultivation.So the film crew leaves the meditation room.
现在禅堂的门呢已经紧闭了，师父呢要在禅堂里面进行一个小时的打坐和修行。今天我在寺庙里面看到师父，无论是行香还是过斋，都非常非常的安静，就是这个字“静”，要求都非常的严格。我想这就是一种修行。
The simple and quiet Ashoka temple is imbued with a religious culture that is more than 1,000 years old. It'sAn auspicious place drenched in golden sunlight.
阿育王寺闻名中外，不仅是因为它的风光秀丽、殿宇巍峨，还有它有着举世瞩目的舍利宝塔。佛教呢都讲究姻缘两字，那我今天到底有没有这个缘分，能够看到佛祖的真身舍利呢
？Built in 1678, the hall housing the relic of Sakyamuni was modeled on the Hall of Harmony of the Forbidden City in Beijing. It has double eaves and yellow glazed tiles.That could be used only for imperial buildings. This shows that the hall housing the relic of Sakyamuni was sacred in the eyes of the feudal emperors. Master Yin Chang is responsible for guarding the relic.
我们这个阿育王是最有特色的一个殿，全国 也只有，就说分叫做舍利店的，也就这么一个。
哦，就专门就是一个舍利店，哎，是吧？
At no more than 30 years old, Master Yin Chang is quite young. Several years ago, he was admitted into a Buddhist seminary. After several years of study, he recently graduated and returned to Ashoka Temple. He tells us that a model of the pagoda housing the relic of Sakyamuni is enshrined in this hall. The real pagoda is bigger, but for safety reasons, the real pagoda is not here. It's in the depository of Buddhist texts, which is not open to tourists. Few people can view the real relic of Sakyamuni. The reporter asks Master Yin Chang if she can view the relic of Sakyamuni. He agrees to ask the abbot, and probably because she asks so sincerely, he grants her request. So Master Yin Chang takes the crew to the depository. He explains, however, that viewing the relic of Sakyamuni is a solemn occasion.
这个次数有规定吗？
这个一般来说都没有，但我们一般来说习惯了，
三次是吧？
Before entering the depository, visitors must put on slippers provided by the temple so as not to bring in any dust.
这个是
餐厅，这个叫青翅龙藏。
The depository is about 500 square meters in area. There are over 1,600 volumes of scripture here, all of them printed several hundred years ago. In the center of the hall, there's a statue of Sakyamuni. The pagoda housing the relic of Sakyamuni is on the incense burner table. The relic of Sakyamuni is housed inside the pagoda.
我们现在在这边来，这位师傅呢，给我们上三根香，一年上三根香。
People who view the relic of Sakyamuni must first offer incense.
现在供奉舍利的这个宝塔就在我眼前，下面这个是水晶是吧？
是的。
Master Yin Chang leads the reporter to the incense burner table.
我们跪下来。
好。
跪下来，差不多这个下巴是在这个位置。你的下巴在这个位置，然后看呢。是从这个舍利子呢，是在这个宝塔的中央部位。你看的时候，一般下巴顶在这个地方，然后看的角度是从四十五度的角度往上看。
仰视是吧？
对对对，仰视。
This small and exquisite pagoda is half hollowed out. It has five stories, and each story has carved Buddha statues. There's a bell at the top of the pagoda, and that's where the relic of Sakyamuni is housed.
是在。
在这个塔的中央部位。
好的哦。
它这个塔是空心的，中间缀的一颗铃，一般来说是金色的。
有光打的地方是吧？
对对对，一般是金色的。然后金色的底下呢，有一颗佛的舍利子，一般人看的话就像。
我看到了，看到了，很小。
一般人。
They finally see the relic of Sakyamuni at the top of the pagoda. The pagoda is very small and narrow, so when you look up.You can't easily see the relic at the top.
我觉得我这样看能看很久很久。
这个是很好的一个。我们一般来说，能拜到佛陀的舍利，能瞻仰到佛陀的舍利，这是一种很大的一种福报。能见到舍利，就等于说亲见到佛陀是一样的。
The relic of Sakyamuni is the size of a mung bean. It's brown or wine red. It is a clear, bright color.According to Master Yin Chang, different people may see the relic as having different sizes and colors. But in fact, the relic's not different, it's the people who are different.
个人的一个，
而且它不是规则的，它是有点椭圆形的是吧？它好像有种吸引力。我刚才刚刚看完，现在又想再看一眼，我想体会一下应成大师他所说的，会不会有所不同。
The pagoda that houses the relic is made of seven precious materials, including gold, silver, and glaze. It's almost as precious as the relic itself.
七宝，我们佛教里面称七宝像金银琉璃车及玛瑙。他把它混碎。我们这个舍利子啊，叫做我们佛教里面讲叫戒、定、慧这三者所成就，才能出这个舍利子。
The relic of Sakyamuni has been enshrined in Ashoka Temple for more than 1,000 years. Countless emperors, kings, generals, and Buddhist faithful have viewed it and prayed for happiness before it. However, the existence of this relic is important not because it brings happiness to people, but because it helps them understand Buddhism, become wise, and make their heart more pure.
今天能够在阿育王寺看到难得一见的这个佛祖的舍利是件非常荣幸的事情，也预示着吉祥如意。从心情呢，从原来的这个激动、兴奋、期待，变成现在一种很平和的心态。我想这也是我在阿育王寺的一种切身的一种体悟。且行好事，莫问前程。阿育王寺呢是一座千年古寺，但是它的古朴、宁静和清幽却让我有些意外。但是从古朴当中透出的这种庄重感，也是他独有的气度。
海浪洗刷了千年沧桑，才展现你向前的力量。海风吹化了千年的冰霜，才重现你停止的脊梁。多少目光把你遥望，你是赤子眷恋的故乡，多少双手把你开创，你是播种梦想的土壤。我爱你，朝霞出发，
春风春雨春雷响亮。